Welcome to our YouTube channel, Wildlife World. If you're moved by the stories of animals, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like our videos. Thanks for joining our community. Watch in disbelief as trained sharks turn on their trainer in a horrifying attack. See how Gabriela Vasquez fought for her life and the tough decisions made by the Animal Conservation Center in the aftermath. This is the terrible account of how sharks attacked Gabriela Vasquez to death at an aquarium. So let me tell you a bit about Gabriela. She works as a shark trader at a public aquarium and animal conservation center in sunny Spain. And get this, she works with real sharks that she trains. If you're thinking, wait, sharks can't be trained, can they? You're not alone. But the truth is that these amazing animals can be coached and trained just like dolphins. The Animal Conservation Center and public aquarium where Gabriela works is a real hit with visitors, especially kids. They've got all sorts of fish species on display, including some impressive sharks. Gabriela is in charge of training two sand tiger sharks, Javier and Alonso. These sharks are generally chill, but they can get fierce if they feel threatened or agitated. Javier and Alonso have their private pad away from the hustle and bustle of the public aquarium. Visitors can swing by and see them up close when they chow down or get their training on with Gabriela. And let me tell you, these sharks are seriously impressive. Thanks to Gabriela's expertise, people always talk about how smart and well-trained they are. What's remarkable is that Javier and Alonso have different strengths when responding to their trainer. Javier is all about the music, while Alonso is more into shapes. Seeing them in action is amazing, and watching how responsive they are to Gabriela's commands is amazing. Experts in the field are also paying attention. They believe that taught sharks like Javier and Alonso could usher in a brand new age of interactions between humans and sharks. Gabriela learns one day that Javier and Alonso will be the featured guests at a live shark feeding display the next day. She is quite happy. This is an opportunity to demonstrate how obedient and well-mannered these sharks can be. Gabriela arrives at work early on the day of the event to check on her fishy pals. As the minutes pass, more people arrive, and anticipation for the main event grows. Gabriela will now finally enter the stage. She stands on a platform surrounded by water in the enclosure and starts feeding Javier and Alonso with little fish and squid, showing off their tricks and commands. The people in the audience are blown away by how well the sharks follow Gabriela's lead. But then something strange happens. When Gabriela runs out of food, the sharks start acting weirdly. They're bumping into her platform and not following her commands like they usually do. The crowd starts to get confused and worried, but Gabriela doesn't panic. She thinks maybe the sharks are just hungry for more food, so she gives out another command, and to everyone's surprise, the sharks follow it perfectly. Gabriela breathes a sigh of relief, and the crowd goes wild with excitement once again. So Gabriela was going about her business, getting ready to grab another food bucket, when suddenly she slipped and fell right into the water, landing on top of Alonso. The crowd of people watching were all gasping and shocked at what they saw. But things quickly went from bad to worse when Alonso got aggressive and started attacking Gabriela. It was terrifying for Gabriela, because she was used to working with and swimming with these sharks. But she never expected them to turn on her like this. Despite her best efforts to swim back to safety, Alonso simply would not let go. Javier began attacking her as well, biting her leg, which made the situation even terrifying as he continued to bite her arm repeatedly. Gabriela was in agony and absolutely defenseless. The two sharks kept biting at her while she yelled in agony. The onlookers were clueless as to what to do. They believed Gabriela had total command of the circumstance. But it was soon obvious that these strong animals were in charge. Luckily, some of the quick-thinking staff and other trainers rushed to the scene and were able to neutralize the sharks with tranquilizers. But the damage was already done. Gabriela was left with severe injuries, and everyone watching was shocked and disbelieving. So, after the terrifying attacks by Javier and Alonso, Gabriela was rushed to the hospital for treatment. She had severe injuries with deep bite wounds on her arm and leg. It was a tough road to recovery, and she struggled to walk for a while afterwards. Meanwhile, back at the Animal Conservation Center, the management team had some tough decisions to make. They had to figure out what to do with Javier and Alonso now that they had attacked their trainer. Some people suggested they be put down, while others thought they should be released back into the wild. The conservation center ended up putting the two sharks in a more secluded enclosure, while they figured out the best course of action. It was a tough time for everyone involved, and the center temporarily closed its doors while they sorted things out. In the end, Gabriela survived the attack, but it was a painful and scary experience for her. And it shows how important it is to treat these wild animals with caution and respect, regardless of how skilled they may appear to be. Keep in mind that wild animals should always be handled with care. Therefore, it's crucial to keep learning safe ways to interact with them. For more enlightening and surprising tales like this, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you for viewing.